And yesterday we also had FIFA Women's World Cup going down. We had England taking on USA. That was bound to be a cracker. It was a cracker. Man, I tell you for free, those ladies do play good football. Those are the kind of games that makes you want to watch now ladies football. Like club football for ladies now. Because, man, the football was entertaining. It was end-to-end. Of course, England and the USA were the most, were two of the most prolific teams you've seen so far in the tournament. The other one is Netherlands. So it was a very entertaining game. However, one thing I don't like about the FIFA Women's World Cup is the VAR. It's taking way too much attention, man. It's like in Copa America. It has taken all the attention and it's... I mean, you don't want to see VAR. You want to see football. And, you know, there was a penalty that was given to England, I think, in the 82nd, was it 82nd or 85th minute? That was not a penalty. That was not a penalty. I don't even know how she missed that ball. Like, it was a cross, a low ball, actually. It was just a low ball, and it was just her to tap it in because it was just her and the goalkeeper. And for a chick who has scored, I don't know, 5 goals so far in the World Cup, that was bound to go at the back of the net. But she just missed it. And then VAR said that was a penalty. That was absurd. That was absurd. I don't think it should have been a penalty. It should not have been given. It's just like another chance where England scored. Then that goal was ruled off for offside. I mean, come on. I mean, there are so many issues to do with VAR. You can talk about them all day with regards to FIFA Women's World Cup. Just like how you can with the Copa America. It's just disappointing. It's just disappointing. But nevertheless, now USA are through to the finals, I think for the third time in a row. That is a record, ain't it? They are the defending champions and looks like they might defend the championship again. The World Championship. So it's going to be interesting to see between Netherlands and Sweden, the other game that is being played today, who's going to be facing USA. Of course, England are now have to set up for playing for the third place playoff. And they will feel hard done. Maybe they should get that. They should get that. They have been prolific for crying out loud. We also had Copa America going on yesterday between Brazil and Argentina, the first semi-final. Brazil won 2-0. And I got to say, man, like Argentina, they really did try. They honestly did try. They hit the post twice. They prodded and prodded and prodded and prodded. But they could not break down Brazil's defense. And I mean, that was the difference between Argentina and Brazil. And Brazil, they did find the back of the net twice. Moving forward, I think Brazil are more clinical. I think they will take the Copa America this year. I'm almost willing to bet they are going to take it. So it's going to be an interesting game to watch. And of course, unfortunately, inachezwa sijui saa 9 na nusu za asubuhi. Because you had a few sequels, sasa hiyo ni asubuhi. So if you can stay up till that time or you can wake up to watch that game, today you can actually watch Chile taking on Peru. That is going to be another cracker. These Copa America games, they are so feisty. They are so high octane. You just can't get bored. You cannot get bored. So yeah, if you can stay up, that is a game to watch out for. As always, don't forget, if you're watching this on YouTube, don't forget to like and subscribe. And if you're watching on Facebook also, you can go to our YouTube channel because we are kind of drifting slowly but surely to YouTube now. So you can go like and subscribe and turn on the notification button just to be on the safe side. All right. Have a fantastic day. God bless.